Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today I'm going to discuss how intermittent fasting and the fact that it increases growth hormone is pretty much a total scam. Now when it comes to losing weight and getting in shape, we just keep recycling the same diet plan every few years. Right now, it's like super cool and popular to be doing intermittent fasting and also ketogenic diet, both of which I did over 25 years ago. And trust me, again, there's nothing new going on. But today I'm going to focus on intermittent fasting and the increase in growth hormone that a lot of people talk about. And I'm doing this because a subscriber asked me the following. Dr. Sam, what's the best way to do intermittent fasting to really increase my growth hormone levels? I've heard that fasting is awesome for boosting GH. I want to increase muscle mass and really get super lean and ripped, and I know GH is the secret. Okay, first of all, there are no secrets to losing weight. There are better strategies based on your body type, your genetics, your food preferences, right, your lifestyle, your goals, and so forth. But trust me, no secrets other than the fact that genetics aside, it's all about optimizing and balancing out key hormone levels that allows for maximum fat burning, appetite suppression, and the preserving of muscle mass. And I'll talk about these hormones in a minute. Additionally, below this video in the description area, there is a link to my website which shows you a specific scientifically researched formula that you can utilize that helps optimize your primary fat burning hormones without any change in your diet or exercise. Now, in regards to GH and intermittent fasting, there's a study that many people who promote intermittent fasting reference, which shows how fasting can increase your growth hormone levels by a massive 1,250%. That's 1,250%, which is really impressive, right? But they leave out the part of the study that involved people who fasted for over 1 week to achieve this increase in growth hormone. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm not going to stop eating for an entire week so I can brag about how much my GH levels shot up while I'm starving to death and all my muscle mass is dissolving. The truth is that stress causes an increase in growth hormone. Thus, not eating, low blood sugar levels, and physical stress will all increase growth hormone. However, this doesn't mean that you're going to be losing fat and gaining muscle. This is very different than the natural GH released with a growing baby and teenagers, which is not stress-related, or the growth hormone released with deep sleep. These are all positive, non-stress-mediated growth hormone release. Just know that there are many hormones involved, and looking at only the growth hormone levels going up during fasting is pretty much elementary and idiotic. Nobody takes into account all the other hormones during the times of stress, such as an increase in stress hormones like cortisol, also a decrease in testosterone, increase in insulin levels, and dozens of other hormonal imbalances. Additionally, other intermittent fasting promoters who fast for 18 plus hours daily say that this is the increase in the GH that's causing all the fat loss. No, it's not, people. It's the fact that most people who do intermittent fasting and are not eating for 18 hours are eating less total calories. This is the primary reason for the weight loss. It's all due to also, in some parts, less insulin secretion, also improved insulin sensitivity. But trust me, the higher GH levels is not the primary cause. Not even close. Listen, I deal with lots of athletes and older people who take lots of high-dose exogenous GH daily, and trust me, they are not burning fat like crazy and walking around at 5% body fat, eating anything they want. Also, if your goal is to build or preserve muscle and lose fat, if you are exercising with weights, please don't fast for 18-plus hours. That's way too many hours to go without eating anything, especially protein. Your body can use stored glucose and fat from your body, right? But the only stored protein is from your muscles, which need to be replenished often. If you go too many hours without consuming some protein, your body will slowly catabolize, right, and eat away at your muscles for the amino acids that it needs to help repair the body and the organs and skin and hair. So you may not notice it right away, but over the next few months, trust me, you will certainly start to lose muscle mass if you're not eating for 18 plus hours daily. So if you want to do intermittent fasting, that's great. But I tell people to maybe fast for about 12 hours at the most. That's it. And that's really a good amount of time. Also, don't go to the gym fasted and lift weights. Your performance will be poor, and you'll also, again, be eating away at the muscle cells. Make sure you eat at least once before you go exercise with some protein. Now, if you're interested in the optimal ways to fast, you know, doing intermittent fasting while still building muscle and or losing fat, let me know below in the comment section, and I'll do a video series about this topic. I know it's really popular. Also, in the meantime, if you do want to burn fat long term and help preserve or even gain muscle at the same time, then your goal is and should be to optimize specific hormones that control fat burning, such as increasing adiponectin, leptin, and thyroid, and also decreasing stress hormones like cortisol and ghrelin, also insulin. As you can see, GH is not on this list, not because it doesn't work or it's not important, but because it's lower on the priority list. Now, below this video in the description area, I've got two important links that I want you to take a look at today. The first is a list of natural ingredients that helps improve these six fat-burning hormones and a few other hormones as well. The second is a proven 20-year formula that causes these hormones to be optimized together, right, in unity, at the same time for maximum fat burning, just the way your body's designed to work. If you found this helpful, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.